A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 29th Jan, on the front page you have NPR in new format can create confusion. So this is Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar, who has said that it's again said that his state will not implement NRC. So though he has supported Citizenship Amendment Act, but the NRC is not being supported by them. So this is it. Then, because this is new format, as we know that it is the parent's date of birth and place of birth which has been proposed to be added to the old format of NPR. Then this is 14 sentenced to life in Gujarat riots case granted interim bail. So Supreme Court has told them to engage in spiritual and social service till appeals are decided. So this is regarding the infamous Kodhra train carnage, which took place on 27 February 2002, in which 51 car sevaks were killed during their return from Ayodhya. And a few days later, a mob entered residential areas in Ode village and surrounded 7 houses where Muslims lived and set them afire. So, the rioters set also a 3-storied pakka building on fire. 23 Muslims caught inside died in that. And the heat was so much that they were burnt to ashes. So these 14 sentenced to life have been granted interim bail. Then below you have African cheetahs to prowl Indian forests. So Supreme Court has lifted 7-year stay on the proposal which was there to introduce African cheetahs from Namibia into the Indian habitat on an experimental basis. So a committee has been formed now to monitor the progress. So it was a plan of 2012 and the Supreme Court had stalled the plan as such. So these cheetahs, African cheetahs, are proposed to be introduced in the Palpur Kuno sanctuary in Madhya Pradesh. The fear was that they might come into conflict with a parallel and much delayed project to reintroduce lions in the same sanctuary. So that time it was not allowed, but now Supreme Court has lifted the stay. And here you have Sharjeel Imam arrested from Bihar village. So this is JNU student Sharjeel Imam, who has been absconding after cases have been filed against him for seditious and inflammatory speeches at Aligarh Muslim University on 16th Jan. And at other places also. So he has been arrested from Bihar village. It is Kako, his ancestral village in Bihar. So he made inflammatory speeches, but then there are opposing views on whether the speeches were inflammatory or not. On page 7 you have Vishwa Bharati evicts student from hostel for recording Vice Chancellor's speech. So Vishwa Bharati University has evicted a student from its hostel for recording on his mobile phone the speech of Vice Chancellor during the Republic Day function. The university said the video was used to defame the Vice Chancellor and therefore the student was responsible. So, on page 8 you have National Green Tribunal sets up panel to oversee removal of debris in Maradu. So in Maradu we saw that posh buildings, apartments, apartmental complex had been set up. It had been erected violating coastal regulation zone norms, that is CRZ norms. So the Supreme Court had ordered their demolition. So they had been demolished buildings, but then the debris removal is still a task. So now a panel has been set up by National Green Tribunal to oversee removal of debris here, and it will also take steps to remove waste fallen in Vembanad Lake. Then below you have Supreme Court gives 10 days for pleas on entry of women in religious places. So Supreme Court bench has been told to examine questions that concern multiple faiths. So all pleas with respect to entry of women in across various religious places. So 10 days have been given for such pleas to be sent in. It is Supreme Court which has set up a 9-judge bench to look into this matter. So when the appeal in Sabrimala to woman entry case came, the Supreme Court formed a larger bench to look into overall issue of such religious questions. So this is about laws arising from practices such as prohibition of women from entering mosques, temples. Then there is female genital mutilation among Dawoodi Bohra community. There is ban on Parsi women who marry interfaith from entering the fire temple. So all these would be looked into in general. So pleas have been sought for 10 days now by Supreme Court. On page 9 you have review of mercy plea rejection is limited. So Supreme Court bench has refused to accede to a request by Nirbhaya case convict on the scope of judicial review of president's decision to reject the mercy plea. So the Supreme Court says this is a very limited, there is very limited scope, and it has rejected such a proposal from Nirbhaya case convict. So they are sentenced to death and they are looking to avert that. So curative petitions have been filed, mercy petitions have been filed, and now review of mercy petition is being sought, which the Supreme Court rejected. Then this is 10 more wetlands in India declared as Ramsar site. So India has added 10 more wetlands to sites protected under the Ramsar Convention. So these 10 new ones are, first one from Maharashtra. So Maharashtra gets its first wetland, which has been recognized by Ramsar as such. So it's a Ramsar site wetland. This is Nandur Madhumeshwar as such. Then there are wetlands from Punjab. There is wetland from Punjab. Then you have from UP, and others are from Rajasthan, Kerala, Orisha, etc. Even from Jammu and Kashmir. So now total of 37 sites in India have been recognized under the international convention, that is the Ramsar Convention. So these are called Ramsar sites. So wetlands declared as Ramsar sites are protected under strict guidelines. So this was a convention signed in Ramsar, which is a city in Iran. So it was Ramsar Convention of 1971. It is one of the oldest intergovernmental agreement for preserving the ecological character of wetlands. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Maharaja on sale. So this is regarding the proposal which was on front page yesterday of 100% stake sale in Air India. So it says the only way to save Air India is by selling it on the best possible terms. So it has a huge debt of around 60,000 crore rupees. So the government's earlier bid to sell Air India did not see by any buyers. So now again a proposal has been made, a second attempt by the present government to sell Air India. So it has sweetened the deal. That was the news yesterday. So that is what is supported by this editorial too. And this is alarming spread. So this talks about World Health Organization. How it cannot deter any longer because coronavirus is spreading, and the World Health Organization has not even declared it as a public health emergency of international concern, or has not given any stringent guidelines as such too. So this is an editorial on that. And this is the lead article, the continuing theme of uncertainty, volatility. So the article says that in 2020, India needs to gear up to face thorny problems on internal geopolitical and economic fronts. So we are facing difficulty internally too, with protests going on, geopolitically too, with adjoining countries, so where in Central Asia also, West Asia, we have concerns which are going to have its consequences for India too, and also on economic fronts. We have seen GDP falling. Then this article is restructuring or bureaucratic overkill. So reorganization of the railway board was in news. So this article says that this is an unexceptional step, but recasting the recruitment system is problematic. So this is regarding the announcement by Railway Ministry in December 2019. It said this is a historic decision of the Union Cabinet to restructure the railway board. So the proposed changes at the board level are like redesignating chairman as chairman and CEO, reducing the number of railway board members. There are 8 members, they will become 4 now, excluding the chairman. Rationalizing the responsibilities on functional lines, and also induction of 4 members from outside the railways hierarchy in an advisory capacity. So these are unexceptional, but also other problems are there, like the recruitment as such. So new cadre has been established, a single service or cadre called Indian Railway Management Service. So UPSC will conduct competitive exams for filling posts here too. So this recruitment system recasting, it is said, is problematic. So So it's there are problems amongst departments, but then merging all the departments, having a single service cater for that is not the way to go ahead with, is what this article is saying. So it says the problem is there significantly in few departments. So, but then overhaul may not be justified. On the OPET page, you have the many problems of delayed data. So this is regarding National Crime Records Bureau, how data from it is delayed. It does not present time bound. So it has to provide time bound and accurate data on crime. Then this is examining the slowdown. So it says Indian economy is facing a structural consumption slowdown, and this is not it states against this that this is not borne by facts, that there is a structural consumption slowdown. So rural demand has reduced, it has been evident. So this article counters such claims. Then on page 12 you have EU motion calls Citizenship Amendment Act discriminatory. So India had wooed pro-India members of European Parliament to soften the resolution, but the final version of the joint motion resolution, which has been tabled by five groups of European Parliament, says the House is deeply the House, that is the European Parliament, deeply regrets the adoption and implementation of Citizenship Amendment Act of India, which is discriminatory in nature and dangerously divisive. And it further calls on the government of India to engage with various sections of the population in peaceful dialogue and repeal the discriminatory amendments which violate India's international obligations. And it also warns against the increasing nationalism which has resulted inter alia in fueling of religious intolerance and discrimination against Muslims. On page 13, you have One Nation Holding Up SAARC. So this says Pakistan's use of terror as a foreign policy tool has promoted radicalism, and India blames Pakistan for not having SAARC progressive. But it is actually conflict between India and Pakistan which has resulted in SAARC not moving ahead with its summits, because India and Pakistan have been together members at various other summits also. Like we have joined SCO, Shanghai Cooperation Organization, together, and the summits there have been going on. India and Pakistan both participated, but not in SAARC. So, and India refuses to participate, saying that Pakistan uses terror as a foreign policy. And this is India France to partner on museums. So India and France will work together in the field of museums, cultural spaces, and research. And a joint working group will be established for this purpose. On international page, you have defying US, UK gives 5G role to Huawei. So this is a Chinese telecom company which USA has targeted, saying that this is close to China and it will use data and send it to China. And it had put pressure on various countries, including India and European countries, to not have Huawei involved in 5G once it is rolled out. But you can see that UK has provided a role for Huawei in 5G, and but the company's involvement will be capped at 35%, and it will be banned from all critical networks. So now you can see with coronavirus, death toll has increased to 106. Even first human-to-human infections have been reported outside China to now. And this is Trump unveils West Asia plan, Palestinians protest. So the proposal which President Donald Trump has unveiled includes Palestinian state with a capital in Eastern Jerusalem and recognition of Israeli settlements. On business page, you have the specific company related news which you don't need to go through, or specific organization news. This is an article, Gold may loses sheen as investment. So it says government initiatives and shifting preferences are expected to slow jewelry demand growth, gold demand growth. And it is said India and China are the one of two of the world's largest markets for gold. So imports have been restricted by Indian government to strengthen the rupee. So taxes have been imposed, and that is affecting the growth in the gold sector. And this is oil firms set to gain as subsidized LPG prices move up steadily. So with the rupees 10 rise per cylinder, subsidy will be nil in 15 months now. So state-owned oil marketing companies have steadily increased the prices of domestic subsidized LPG by 63 rupees over the last 6 months. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.